Hey, what's going on, fight fans? This is Sean with Boxing Social and Other Sports. And man, before we get into it, man, you see that? Click on that Cash App, $ Boxing Socialist, or you can hit my PayPal up down in the description, Streaming Labs, however you want to donate, help your boy out. But I thought that we had a knockout, dragout war when we watched the Errol Spence versus Sean Porter fight. Two top decorated fighters, and I believe they seen each other in the amateurs. If they didn't fight in the amateurs, they knew of each other in the amateurs. And they put on a bar burner this past weekend, this Saturday night. But what people don't know is that there was a celebrity boxing match going on. And who is that with? Fousey versus Slim. Let me read you a little bit of what some of the article talked about. It said, the sport of boxing has been around for hundreds of years, which we know that. But it's becoming a phenomenon between YouTubers. You know what? You know, even growing up, you know, your family and friends would tell you, hey, man, you got beef or you got a problem with such and such person. Man, you ain't got to pull out no gun. You ain't got to hit somebody to have the bat and all that, man. If you want to get something off your chest, man, put on the gloves. Get in there and go scrapping. Man, even if you don't have a boxing ring or anything in your area, man, people put on gloves all the time and, you know, just fight around their friends and, you know, they build yourself like a little circle so you can't run 100 feet away while somebody's trying to chase you. But recently they talked about the British pair, KSI and Joe Weller. They made history when they headlined the first show. And then KSI ended up parlaying to the fight with Logan Paul. And I think I saw clips when they fought. I think it was sometime last year. And I think Logan Paul etched out the win over KSI. And lo and behold, you know, they're about to do a rematch. And that's coming up. And like, they're actually mixing this with professional boxing, which is really just blowing my mind. Like, I don't mind. You know, you should have like a whole card full of YouTubers, social media influencers. Like, have like a 6-bout, 8-bout card, man, and stream that all on YouTube. Let YouTube do all the promotions, setting it up and all that. I just don't like YouTubers or and all that. And I'm not to say that y'all couldn't be nothing in your career or future if you really trained from like a kid up and really took it serious, but don't mix that up with like professional boxing, man. I just feel like it kind of just taint the sport of boxing. The funny thing is, I don't see any of these YouTubers getting it in with, doing a UFC style. And I don't know if that's because they don't want to get kicked, hit, punched, you know, with the smaller gloves, or they just feel boxing is a little bit more safer. I don't know. But anyway, it goes on with the two set for a long-awaited rematch November 9th. That's KSI and Logan Paul. But to no avail, we got here. Fousey, too, suffered a pretty devastating loss inside the ring. So let's go over. Let's look at some of the things that the announcer talked about. On September 29th, Fousey took on fellow YouTuber Slim. I don't even know who Slim is. I mean, I've seen Fousey before. Like, I used to see him, he's like doing some kind of like motivational speaking or something along those lines. He does some kind of inspirational stuff. And next, you know, I heard something about he was throwing a party and he said Drake was gonna be there. And Drake was like, man, I don't even know who this guy is. Blase, blase, and then that fell through. And then somebody did like a thread and I don't know what all happened. And I think I saw him in some kind of Madea, Boo, Halloween, or something like that. That's how I really got to know who he was. It's amazing how these people be on YouTube, but you don't really know who they are until they actually get in a movie. Or is it vice versa? You can be in a movie and go on YouTube and you get more notoriety. Anyway. So it's Hassan here. Early in the opening round, he threw some wild punches looking for a knockout blow. Pretty early on, but Slim found his footing by throwing out jabs and using movement to his advantage. Unlike a fight between professional fighters, where there's usually a filling out period in the early goings, Fousey kept his foot on the gas pedal and tried to score the victory. Yet all he appeared to do was tire himself out. Listen, that's exactly what I was about to say. People that don't really have experience in boxing, like, you can go and you can work pads and you can run a couple miles and you can get in there and do like some light sparring or whatever you want to do. I don't even know how many rounds it's for. I don't know if it's 4 or 5, 6 rounds, but you know, when you're not used to that, you never, ever, ever go in and punch yourself out in the first round. Number two, let me tell you, all boxers that don't have no experience, what tires you out? Nervousness, being tense, being tight. You ever see guys get in there and they ball their fists so tight and they're shaking and they're swinging for the fences? Do you know how much energy that exerts? I read an article one time. People that have zero experience and they ball their fists up tight and they swing and they don't breathe and their energy is so sapped, they said they've some experts say it's equivalent to a person having a seizure. When a person having a seizure, their body locks up and they just start shaking, and by the time they're done having a seizure, like, they're like exhausted, their body's drained, and all they want to do is just lay down and sleep. People with no experience and they lock up like that and afraid to get hit and they can't control their breathing and they're trying to get themselves together. Same type of way. It says here the YouTuber, still talking about Fousey, was subjected to a standing 8 count in the first round as he failed to defend himself. Listen, boxing isn't all about offense. You need to have some defense. I mean, it can't be punch, 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 punch. You got to learn to slip, move, jab, pace yourself, which none of this really helped Fousey. And at the end, I'm going to tell you what gym he was training out of. And I'm sure these trainers told him that, but he did. See, it's one thing. Mike Tyson always said, everybody has a game plan until you get hit, right? Then all that goes out the window. It says after taking another 2 counts in the second and third round. Man, how much of a beating were you taking, Fousey? Man, it said Fousey's corner finally stepped in to end the contest in the fourth round as he staggered across the middle of the ring, failing to show any sort of resistance to Slim's punches. Listen, either Slim is one heck of a fighter, man, that was throwing them hands, or either he has some previous experience in boxing, but darn. I don't know what to say about, you know, Fousey, but I will say this. I have to give you credit, man, because a lot of people don't even have the heart to step into a boxing ring and do anything at all. So I have to give you props just for that alone. It says after the fight was over, the fans feared for any potential injuries, and a YouTube star finally revealed via Instagram that he had broken his nose in the fight. Well, he didn't break it. Slim broke it. He congratulated Slim on the victory, knowing that he had earned a win even though Fousey had trained the hardest and possibly could have in a build-up. So here's what Fousey posted in his Instagram. And he says, you win some and you lose some. That's just how it happens. At the end of the day, I gave it my all. I trained the hardest I possibly could in 2 months, and I came prepared. Now, here's where it lets you know who the coaches were. I can't thank my coaches, Ten Goosen Boxing Gym, Team Funes 93, enough for investing so much time and energy into my life. I love y'all. A massive congrats to Slim. You came, you saw, you conquered. Enjoy the win, bro. You deserve it. And P.S. My nose was bad enough before having it broken, so screw you for that. And then, of course, he gave his little laughy ha-ha sound and put a little heart at the end. I know it's all love. I think that's it. That's it for Slim. Not Slim, but for Fousey. I don't think he's going to be getting in the ring anytime soon. Even though they can probably make a lot of money if he was to fight somebody like KSI or Logan Paul. But let's see, man. Listen, it's a charity event. It's not to be taken serious. It's a free-for-all. You throw it, see what happens, see if you come out the win. But please, don't mix it like this KSI Logan Paul. Man, just don't mix it, man, with professional boxing. Have your own YouTube boxing events. money to be made in it. It's for a charity. I don't know who they were giving it to, but it was for a good cause. Till next time, this is Sean with Boxing Social and Other Sports. We signing out.